Hi, and welcome to Kodi4u. In today's episode, I will guide you through installing the Bromix repository for XBMC Kodi. The Bromix repository contains several popular add-ons for XBMC Kodi, and although most of them are also available on the official xbmc.org repository, it can be very useful to have the developer's repository manually added to ensure that you always have the very latest version, especially when you're encountering bugs. This repository currently contains 13 different add-ons. However, the developer is constantly adding new content to both this and the official xbmc.org repository. The Bromix repository is home to add-ons developed by Bromix and houses popular add-ons such as 7TV, MyVideo.de, BreakPictures, BreakVideos, 9Gag, and SoundCloud. Please have a look at the description for information on where to obtain support for the add-ons developed by Bromix and where you can contribute to the source code. Okay. So as you can see, this is a clean install of Kodi 14.0 Helix Beta 2. I'm using a MacBook Pro running OS X Yosemite for this demonstration. However, steps should be fairly similar on all other platforms and devices depending on the capabilities of your device. The steps are also identical if you manually want to install any other zip file. In order for us to add the Bromix repository, we will first need to download the zip file from GitHub. To do so, open a web browser and visit bit.ly/bromixrepo, or you may also use the original URL on GitHub. Both these URLs can be found in the description of this video as well. Next, place this downloaded zip file on a USB drive, a network drive, or you may also access local storage if that is possible, and place it in a folder that is conveniently accessible for your device. In my case, I've placed the zip file on a USB drive. To install the zip file, you will want to go to System, followed by Settings. Next, click Add-ons in the bottom left, and if you haven't installed anything yet, click on OK to continue. Click on Install from Zip File, and then navigate to the location of the downloaded zip file. Again, this could be local storage, network storage, or any attached storage as well. I've placed it on my USB drive, so I will go to my drive. Finally, click the zip file, and the repository or add-on will be installed. And that is it. The repository has now been installed, and we can now browse any of the available add-ons from the Bromix repository. To do so, click on Get Add-ons and select Bromix Add-ons. Next, click on the category of your interest. However, most of the add-ons available are video add-ons. Here you can see the available add-ons for you to explore. As mentioned, there are a few non-video add-ons available as well in this repository. Should you run into any issues with no add-ons being displayed, please open the settings panel on the left and ensure that you have not selected Hide Foreign, as the developer listed all of his add-ons as foreign add-ons, considering that the majority of the add-ons available are in fact for German sources. Alright, that is it for this video. I hope you liked it. If you did, please like this video by clicking the thumbs up, subscribe to our channel, and leave a comment on what tutorial you would like to see next. Thank you for watching, and see you next time.